Everybody, welcome back to an all-new episode of the Cineverse.
Today we're here at the Lemley Six in the Encino Town Commons.
We're going to check out the new British spy thriller, Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy.
Let's check it out. Tomas Alfredson is not a first-time director, but I kind of felt that way. I mean, it's clear that he knows how to direct, but I'm not sure he knows what to direct. The film felt slow. I think most of that comes from the way he chose to tell the story. Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy is a slow burn of a movie. Now, I really think it was well made, with a lot of attention paid to detail, but it was weighed down by its own Britishness. Let me explain. I've always thought that the Brits don't find the need to keep a story moving. They just let it happen organically, and that takes time. So maybe it's the American in me who longs for things to happen, because in this film, they didn't. Don't get me wrong, again, it was well made, but I think it would be better as a BBC miniseries. But thank God for popcorn and caffeine.
First off, this is easily Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy's strongest point. With talents like Gary Oldman, Colin Firth, Mark Strong, Ciaran, Hinds, Tom Hardy, John Hurt, how could it not be? Each one of these men is at the top of the profession. You could have had them read the phone book and it would have been an Oscar-worthy performance. Oldman's turn as George Smiley was excellent. The old spymaster is a fun part to play. One of the problems was that while the other actors and characters were all well done, you didn't get a chance to know them as well as you would like.
So something that audiences have really been into the last few years are period pieces. I mean, we can't get enough of them. And we seem to be focusing on the 60s as a decade to see. Something about the clothes and the music, we just really dig that style. Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy. God, that's a mouthful. Anyway, it was a very stylish film. The suits, the music, the smoke, everything set the mood and the period came across perfectly. I think they did it so well that the Oscar for Best Art Direction is something in their future.
From great spy fiction writer John le Carré, Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy is your standard British Cold War movie. It's all about British intelligence searching for a mole inside their own ranks. Very tense, very exciting, or so the trailer would lead you to believe. This isn't really the case, though. The story had far too much information to get through for its 2-hour running time, and this leads to many problems. The biggest being that we don't really have the time to get to know anybody. So when things really start happening, you're left not caring about anyone, and that's no good.
There's a rotten apple, Jim. And we have to find it.
Alright guys, so Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy. Is it worth your money in the theater?
Not really. It's definitely an Academy film. If you're into that sort of thing, you'll like it. But honestly, it's not worth the ticket prices these days.
It's really not. It's kind of boring. It's well made, but not very good. Wait to DVD.
Yeah, it's all about the art direction, this one. It's definitely worth waiting for.
Yeah, DVD it. All right, guys. That wraps up this episode of The Cineverse.
Any questions, comments, or concerns, please feel free to email us.
Also, the full review of Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy blog, please.
Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Like us on Facebook.
Follow us on the Twitter.
All the above.
And join us next time when we come back for our season finale, where we're doing two movies. We're going to do David Fincher's The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo.
And we're going to see Tom Cruise in Mission Impossible Ghost Protocol.
Yes, indeed. It'll
that
be a good one.
Fun. It should be fun.
Until next time, guys. See you at the theater.